Our guest this afternoon is Vidit. How are you doing, Vidit?
Well, I'm doing good. I'm very happy, very relieved to win a game because it was a tough match yesterday. The game was really, really tense. So I'm very happy to win and not going to tie breaks.
Let's start off with the game for today and then I'll ask you a question about yesterday's game. So obviously after the result of yesterday, a win today would have been fantastic for you. You've achieved this win. Tell us a bit about the game and about this bishop blocked in 1b1.
Yeah, it's a very standard idea that white tries to provoke c5, c4. And then the thing is, if he manages to remove the bishop, then he has a very good position. And black's entire play is based on avoiding that. So I think he misplayed in the opening. Like, it was not really bad. I think it was roughly equal. But he played too slow. He played this move h3. And after that, I had this very nice trick of playing c3 and, you know, completely locking in the bishop on b1. So the rest of the game was just basically like I'm playing with an extra piece. Of course, I have to be careful, but I think I played a good game.
The computer validates your assessment, so that is clear. And it's an important win that allows you to move on to the next round without having a tiebreak tomorrow. So it's an extra rest day for you.
That's a relief. Like, you know, all the rest days I can get, I would happily take, because this tournament has been so long. It's very tiring, but I'm very happy with the results, so I can't really complain at all.
Okay. So now is the moment to talk about yesterday's game. Just this knight d6 and the queen g6 check idea that it seemed that you didn't see or miscalculated. You took 3 minutes to play queen f4. Take us through your thought process at that moment.
I don't exactly recall everything, but Of course, every move I was considering knight d6, and this was so obvious. Like, there's nothing to calculate. If I play this, I just win the game. But I think I was checking h6. I was a bit surprised by h6. And in some lines, I was going with the queen to f4. Like bishop b7 something, queen f4 is one of the moves. So I thought, I get for free queen f4, and I just played quickly. That was my problem. Had I thought a bit, of course, you see knight d6, and then it's just like simple. And I think I might have, I don't know, it's kind of shameful to say, but I might have missed knight d6, queen d6, e d6, hg5, and the rook is hanging.
It's hanging, Richard.
Maybe something like this. I mean, I don't exactly know, but yeah, it could be.
Well, I suspected with only 3 minutes of thought that maybe it wasn't a miscalculation of a long line. It might have been just you were thinking of queen f4 in some other variation, and you went for it.
Exactly. I was thinking about it at some different lines, and I chose the wrong moment to play.
Okay. The game was very complicated. Anything could have happened, but you hold the draw, and today you've won. So do you know your opponent for the next round?
No. How does the pairings work?
Okay. I don't have them at hand, but in any case, you'll see it soon.
I'm board 4, so I will play board 5. Like, 1 will play 8, 2 will play 7, 3 will play 6, 4 will play 5, if we go by logical pairings. But well, yeah. And maybe Duda versus Grishuk, I think one of them.
I've been running all around today, so it's shameful for me not having that to hear, but we'll, in any case, we'll see it soon.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.